Did you ever wonder how AI processes speech?
Which looks like this into text.
And how you can make this process more accurate and more reliable? In this video, I'll show you how speech-to-text works and how to fine-tune it for your domain-specific use cases. This matters because inaccurate recognition leads to higher error rates, increased debugging time, and it slows down your development and decreases your reliability. So if you're building voice-enabled apps or virtual agents, understanding how speech-to-text works and how you can customize it for your domain-specific requirements, this can make or break your accuracy. We'll break it down into three parts. First, how it works. Second, why customization matters. And third, how to do it right for phone-based AI. So let's take a look at an example of how this works. Let's take an audio form that looks like this. And this was to represent open an account. And I've got the two little peaks here for the accents on account. So the job of speech to text is to take this audio waveform and turn it into this text. And what it does is it works by constructing phonemes, which are the smallest units of words, and constructing them into a sequence that makes sense. These models, they're very good at common phrases. So if you think about open an account, this happens in banking, it happens in retail, it happens in insurance, it happens in lots of different places. Everyone's opening accounts. Something in the middle is perhaps file a claim, right? It's a phrase that a lot of different domains have, and there's still pretty good context here. But sometimes you have completely domain-specific things like the periodontal right wing x-ray. This is a phrase that you'll only see at the dentist's office. And can you imagine if you were a speech-to-text engine and you heard someone say this phrase here? How in the world would you turn that to the right phonetic sequences? You've probably never heard it before. And that's why customization is so essential for improving model performance in these specific domains. Because again, the way that works together is speech uses context clues to improve recognition. So the recognition of the word account is boosted by the fact that you've heard the person say open an account before. There's very good cohesion in that phrase, and hearing the open and, you're kind of expecting the word account. When you hear this phrase without knowing the domain, you have no idea what's coming, right? But let's take something that's kind of in the middle, and that's this claim one. So if someone says file a claim, there's great context here because you have file and a claim, and claims are filed, and that all kind of all makes sense. It's a sequence you hear a lot. But in voice solutions and phone solutions, callers will actually often only say the one word. They'll just say claim. And there's a real challenge for the speech-to-text engine because there's no other context other than that single word. And worse, claim is made up of four phonemes, one for the C, one for the L, one for the vowel sound, and one for the M. And because you don't have any context helping you understand that this is the word claim, there's a lot of words that sound like this, from clean to climb to blame to plane. You can imagine it's the world's worst game of Boggle to put all these different words together, all these sounds together. And so you use customization to shrink the search space for the language model so it has a chance to get this word accurately. So let's look at how you would actually train the model or to customize that model. And the technique you use is called creating a language corpus. So the corpus is a list of words or phrases that you expect the model to encounter. And you use this corpus to give the model a nudge that, hey, these are phonetic sequences that are going to occur in my domain. So in my corpus, I'd probably have the word claim, claim and claims, I would have the bite wing, x-ray, I would do periodontal. I would do any words or phrases or sequences that are common in my domain that aren't common in general language usage. And by doing this, I'm giving the model a nice nudge to say, when you hear certain sequences, like those two vowels, those two consonant sounds followed by the vowel, that it's more likely to be claimed than some other word like planes or climbs or things like that. So sometimes you don't know exactly what the search space looks like, but you have a pretty good idea, and a corpus is great for that. But sometimes you know exactly what it will look like. So let's take the case of a phone-based AI that's collecting member IDs. And let's say we know that member IDs follow a very specific format. It's always a letter followed by a sequence of numbers. Let's say for our use case, it's one letter followed by six numbers. Here we can create a much more rigid set of rules for the language model called a grammar. And that grammar says, whatever the user is saying is going to fall into this kind of sequence, and therefore I have a much smaller search space to go through when I'm putting phonetic sequences together. This is particularly helpful in reducing common confusions for things that sound like each other. So let's say I heard a member ID, and I couldn't tell if that middle letter there was a 3, or an E, or a C, or a B, or a D, or any of those letters that sound the same. When I'm using a grammar, I know if it's in the fourth spot, it's the 3. And this helps me reduce a huge class of errors. It greatly improves my accuracy if I know what's coming. So that's how speech-to-text works and how you can customize it to make your conversational AI more accurate and more reliable. Whether you're building virtual agents or voice applications, customizing speech recognition makes all the difference.